My greeting goes to all the ushers, the wonderful choristers and the choir master.
Amen.
Even if you are not singing today, this greeting is for you. The deaconess should not say that our thought maybe they have been forgotten. Everybody knows, ladies, women, they are the leaders of the gospel. At this time, there are some groups that are very important in this sanctuary that that their names are not brought up. And that's my family. In the person of Sister Ekpo and Master Mike Ekpo, please will you all stand so that your presence be recognized.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The scripture has been read from the book of Ephesians, the 6th chapter, from verse 10 through verse 18. There is the the identity of a group. Before you can hear very well today, to make whose banner are you bearing very clear and understandable, I had a good story to give you. It's all about a man who was young, and grew old, a man who became a king, and that is David. David was the son of Jesse. The father of Jesse was Obed. The father of Obed was Boaz. But you see, if I continue to say this, it may take a very long time. But in the book of Matthew, the first chapter, the first verse, David, Jesus, the son of David, is in your Bible. Jesus who? The son of who? David. That's why I choose that. As a childhood, David was a shepherd. He was the eighth son of the children of Jesse. The elders, they were left to the war. The young one was sent to the field to kill himself. It was then God directed a prophet by name Samuel to get to the house of Jesse. That he has somebody there who would be a king. Remember, there was a king already. When the children of Israel asked God about kingship, God always be the king of Israel. But because the children of Israel have been saying, people have been killing this, oh God, we want king. God told them so many things will happen. You want a king? Okay. But so many things will happen. Well, he ordained for them a man called Saul. And Saul was a king. Saul did what was not right in the face of God. Therefore, he was rejected. To reject him, they must replace somebody. Because the people said they need a king, okay? When Samuel went to Jesse's house, they were tall people, big, smart, intelligent, well educated, those who are trained. In the olden days, to be well trained or considered educated, you have to master the army protocols or disciplines. So when these people came, one by one, none was selected. Samuel knew that God cannot lie. God told him, in that family of Jesse, there is a king. Then Samuel has to inquire from the dad, from Jesse, is this all the children that you have? Well, this is one who lives in the farm, doing nothing, and those are guinea pigs. So there's one left in the farm. Okay, Samuel directed that they should send for him and be brought here to see what God is going to do. So they brought David from the farm. And immediately, David touched or saw Samuel. It was something, a vibration. And this vibration unites also in the body of Samuel. This is him. without much, without any hesitation. Samuel anointed David as a king. Well, remember, David's, his main work is to take care of his sheep. So what happened when David was anointed as a king? Did he have to take over the kingship? No. See, when we went to conference, church conference at Namibia, Birmingham, Alabama, everywhere, when a pastor is being ordained or so, when it comes to this church, he will not just come immediately. There are so many things to do. He has to learn about his new commission. So David was brought to the palace of Saul, because Saul was still the king, even though they ordained David. If I use the word ordained, I mean anointed. So don't get mixed. I want you to know that all is almost the same, is the same. David now was brought to Saul, the palace. The book of Samuel tells us that David bare the armor of Saul. He was very, very good in singing. He was very, very good in dancing. He was a composer of songs. Most of the hymns, most of the things you read in the book of Psalms, those were majority of them are the works of David. One, there was war. Something's worrying Saul, because Saul learned that David had been anointed king over Israel. There is something, some animosity generating in his heart. Okay? So every time they have dinner, this man will pick up his spear. What is he doing? He will just throw that spear right in the direction of David. Remember, David had a banner. This banner, you can't break it. He has an act of the living God. Very hard to destroy the man called David. Well, conflicts. David left the palace, ran away from his father's house, keeping on caring for the sheep. But he has been hearing words, stories about a man named Goliath. A man named Goliath that brought problems to David. Goliath does what? See, I've been hearing of the God of Israel that he made the water to dry. He dried the river. He opened the way in the river. I have heard that he fed in the wilderness. That he broke water in the desert. Let that God help him now. I want somebody among the children of Israel who can come and stand in front of me and let us and change what we know. He was really proud of his military training, his military might, his power, his strength. And if you see this man, I read in Jerome's commentary, that man was a monster. Everybody that sees this man will be afraid of.
Thank you.
the God of Israel, who is the God of armies. Well, something happened. They removed everything. Okay, give me a bread. Give me a bread. He went into the stream and selected smooth stones. He has a sling. In Nigeria or English, we call catapults. Put it down. He's ready to go. The man David is ready to approach the world's strongest man of his days. What happened? When Goliath saw David coming, there was a big laugh.
That's right.
You think I'm a puppy? not a real dog.
Church without men is a dead church.
You know, say you rose on the third day, it was women who did. Women? Be careful. They were singing their name, they were all they like to go in the group.
And killed, or they say he brought When this king, when King Saul was killed, the person who killed King Saul brought the news to David, thinking that David will give him a lot of money, not knowing that this is a man of God. When the news, what you say you did? You kill Saul, the anointed. He asked that he should be killed. So he was killed. Now that he was killed, the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom do what? They are next and become one. Everybody say now he is dead. David was made a whole overall. David had a problem too. With the defeat of the Jebusites in a place known as Jerusalem, David married too many wives and counted the sons of his. But the life of that man, I told you, it's the story I'm giving you. He only different that when he made a mistake, he will shout and kneel down and put sackcloth and surrender, even to a chicken.
Yes.
Yes.
That's the difference between David and other kings. Most people, when they are in authority, they will humiliate people that are under them. Even when they are wrong, if you say it's wrong, what will happen to you? You are demoted. You are fired. Fired. You might be hearing words like that. David, when they told him of the evil that he has done, I'm not here to talk too much about the evils, because you people knew what he did. Every one of you have great preachers. He killed the person that ushered him to become the overall king of Israel. Whose banner are you wearing? Whose banner are you wearing? Now, I want to tell you from the scripture, we learn that the spirit of God is the sword of God, and that is the word of God. When you read Gospel according to John, he says that. Because if I go with the story of David, believe me, I can discuss this man even biblically. 2 or 3 days, I'm not tired. Because I know. Not me, but the Father. But read Gospel according to St. John, the first verse. It reads, I'm just putting it from. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was God. And what happened? And the Word is God. Jesus said in the book of Revelation, behold, I'm standing at the door and knocked. Anybody that will open the door for me, I will get close to him. We talk about the word of God. The only armor, the only banner, the only seal that we strive to be. Because whosoever will bear the arm of the most living God.
Amen.
based on the mouth of Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus and God, they are one. The only difference, this is number one, and this is the spoke person, and that's Jesus. He died that we may have life. Whose armor are you wearing? Whose armor are you wearing? Are you wearing the armor of God? Or you just wear your own God, which is faith? I'm trying to brief. I prepared 20 something pages. I could only go through a few. Because you can't stand. Don't be mad. It's too long. The word of God should not be declared too long. If somebody is giving a reviving gospel that you have known,
Jesus.
you build a good palace, you have already become great. When the woman who 12 years is you heard about Jesus, he inquired, and she was told that it will be very hard for you to get to him. Then he decided, if I could even touch the hem, for what I heard, if I can touch the hem, I'm sure I will be healed. Look at him, he has already conceived this in his mind. Mind is power. He went there. What that woman heard was a fact. He could not get to Jesus. So many people, very struggle and get to there. And immediately she was healed.
Yes.
Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hold somebody's hand again and ask him, whose banner are you bearing? I don't want you to forget that. Hold somebody's hand and ask him, whose banner are you bearing?
Banner are you holding? Are you
bearing? You're not touching nobody. Please touch somebody. Nobody get a disease today. I declare all diseases banned. They will never be, no, nobody can contact any disease. In the name of an average age, trust in drug remedy. Amen. You cannot get any bad thing from this church today. All what you can get from is good news and power. Do you have a problem of getting money? Is money really a hard thing? If you have the mind, most of the biblical preparations told me about the mark of Jesus. I make it easy, the way of God. Where is money? The book of Acts, the second chapter, the 8th verse, tells us that Jehovah God, the very God who sent Goliath, control money. See, that is written, gold and silver are mine. Gold and silver are mine. It belongs to the God Almighty. He can give to anybody he wants. And if that is the problem, you can get it. You get it today. By believing, you get it. Do you have a sickness that it has been declared that nobody can heal it? Nobody can cure it. The Bible says, is anything impossible with God? It's in the Bible. Is anything impossible with God? And I want people to answer, no. Is anything possible, impossible with God?
No.
Can God do all things?
Yes.
Can God do all things?
Yes.
The more you believe, the more you shout out, you receive the word.
Amen.
Do you ever try to be married? Marriage is not good. Too much fight in the house. Have you checked yourself? Do you have the mark of Jesus? One of the mark of Jesus is what? Love. It's written that everything in this world will pass. But for love, it remains in the living. That's forever. Because somebody is wrong. So you have to treat him because he's wrong? When he saw Goliath sleeping, he made like this, the sleep was very serious. Caught him. He did not kill him. He forgave him. Why should not you learn to forgive? Why should you not? is one of the banners. Do you have problems at your workplace? That you even decided that you will quit. Instead of waiting to be fired, nobody will fire you. Go back to that place with the armor of the true living God. In the next month, you have a promotion. I want somebody to put on and say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want somebody to put your hand up and say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
See, sometimes you have to prove, my husband. I hear you, my singer. Today, you are asked, what can you prove that you belong to Jesus? Can you prove by rewarding evil for evil? Can you prove by giving hate for hate? Can you prove by quitting? Can you prove because you want people to clap hands for you? That was what Saul was looking for. But since these women, they clap hands too much. The hand that they clap for David Pass, when they clap for him, he lost everything. He died in the battlefield. So, I'm going to be good. But finally, I want you to put on the armor of God. Hatred, telling somebody that he's not fit for something. Nobody gave you that chance. God is the one who can tell someone not good. Think of yourself. Let you point finger and five finger is pointing to you. Or what? You point on the world, it will point to you. Whether you are the causative agent of the problem you are having. If you believe that you are for the Lord, you are in need for the Lord. God is not mad whatsoever a person sows. You don't want to receive the preaching? No problem. God is not mad. God is not mad. Because what you sow definitely is what you reap. David stand for the truth. He knew that the rock, he apologized. That is why in Matthew 1, verse 1, he said, Jesus, the son of David. It would be very hard for one to believe from the message that that man has done, that the scripture will remember his name. He has a name next to Moses, Abraham, Isaac, Moses and Abraham. The third name is the name David. So now, if you hear these words, if you receive these words, may the God Almighty put that banner in you. The witches see you, I declare, will run away. The accident will run away. The house that is hot is going to be cold. No one in the house I quench in a month is gone because of the mark. Because when the children of Israel put that mark, the blood of the sheep on their doorpost, when the evil came, he passed. So I put the same mark on your face today. In the name of Jesus, I have that authority as a preacher to ask the Father to put the man on you. May God bless you. May God be with you. Now, praise the Lord.
Amen.
For the healing. If you have heard the word today, have a church that you belong to, if you would like to be a member of this church, or if you would like to have the mark of the living God